are these structures that are inside the report where we can see the order date, last name, here's our title, things like that. These are called controls. And in reports and in forms also, you'll learn later, controls are different structures that you can use to build your forms and reports. Right now, we're just using two different kinds. This one up on the title, and these guys down here that are used for the titles of the columns, these are label controls. The ones down here, it looks like they just repeat the data, but these are different. These are text boxes, and a text box can tie to a field in the table. Or it can have, like we can see on the bottom, it can actually have formulas inside. So two different controls, label and text box. There are a lot more controls. If you go up to design on the menu, this is the symbol, and you'll find this not only in Access but in other programs for a text box. Notice it says text box. And this is a label, so those are the two we're using now. Also, you can have buttons, and you won't use a button in a form because you're just going to print it out, but on forms we'll use buttons. Tab controls, you can use those in forms quite a bit. Again, you won't use that in a report. Links to websites, option buttons. There's quite a few different ones. Here's a checkbox, you're familiar with that. Here's an option button that would go inside of an option box like this. Let me show you an example using Access itself. If I click on File and I go to Print, and I'll just go to Print, but I won't really print anything. This is a dialog box. That's what they call these. And you've used these in Windows a million times, but it's made up of controls. This top thing where I can select the printer with a pull down, that is a combo box. You'll use those in the forms. This is a button, a command button. Over here, the print to file, that's a checkbox. Here's an option button. You can't quite see it, but there's always a box surrounding the option buttons. And the idea is if you click one, it unchecks the other, or unclicks the other one. This from to on the pages, these are both text boxes, these little guys here. And then there's, this is a what they call a list box. And it's got a little control where I can increase or decrease the value. So all of these are controls, and the main ones, I'll click cancel here, the main ones you'll use on your reports are just the two, the labels and the text boxes. It's easy to change these labels. Let's say up here on the top, we wanted this to be order listing. Now you notice I clicked on it, and the first click gave me this highlighting around the edge. The second click, I clicked between the R and the S, and I've got an insertion bar. So I can press the space bar and type the word listing, and I'll hit delete. And then I can click off of this to unselect it. And so now I've changed the label. If I wanted it more centered, I could actually just click and hold and drag it. Move it out here into the middle. Go ahead and try that. And then once you're done, let's go back here to Print Preview by clicking on the pull down on the left side and going to Print Preview. And let me go up to the top. I'm still scrolled down to the bottom. Not quite big enough, but it is in the middle. So I'm going to close Print Preview. This needs to be wider, even though it's showing wide enough here. Sometimes that happens. Now notice on the selection box, there are these little buttons in the corner, little boxes. If you click on, or if you put your cursor over one, I get little angle arrows on the edges. You probably won't use these too much. You will some, but mostly you'll use this one on the right side. If you put your cursor over it and get a double arrow, it lets you stretch the box. So now that I've stretched that, I'm going to go back to Print Preview. There, now I've got enough room. So I'll close Print Preview. We're going to do a lot more manipulation of these, and we'll find out how to manipulate these text boxes and the size of the detail section in the next lecture.